This is the Mercedes 725.0 transmission, the 9 G-tronic. And this was actually introduced in 2013 and either augments or replaces the 7 G-tronic, the 722.9 on many of the late model Mercedes vehicles. This is a 9-speed automatic transmission, totally electronically controlled. One feature that you'll notice that makes the 9 G-tronic easily identifiable is it has no external manual linkage whatsoever. All control is electronic via the CAN bus, CAN high, CAN low. Let's go ahead and just take a look at the case here as we spin the transmission around. We'll notice that it looks very much like the 7 G-tronic. In fact, actually, it's a little bit lighter and a little bit shorter. Normally, the 7 G-tronic, the 722.9, would have a manual linkage, but we have no manual linkage whatsoever. One interesting feature is we have an off-axis chain-driven oil pump and an electric pump there in the case. Just like the 7 G-tronic, I actually have an aluminum bell housing that's bolted to a magnesium aluminum case. Now, as we'll see in just a moment when we disassemble the transmission, magnesium aluminum is usually quickly identified by a bluish gray color. But you look at this and you say, well, that doesn't look bluish gray. Well, there's actually a coating on the case to help prevent it from weathering. But as we disassemble the transmission on the inside, just from the exposure to the atmosphere of the air, and after cleaning the transmission fluid away from it, you'll see that it's picking up a bluish gray tint. And then, of course, the infamous plastic pan. Both CF and Mercedes have gone to the integrated filter within a plastic oil pan. There are actually two filters. One filter is for the engine-driven pump, and the other filter is for the electric pump. So now we'll go ahead and disassemble the 9 G-tronic. Here we have the Mercedes 9 G-tronic, the 725.0 9-speed automatic transmission. Aluminum bell housing, magnesium aluminum case. And as we start the disassembly process, the first thing we need to do is remove the plastic oil pan. Now, this oil pan incorporates the two filters for the engine-driven pump and the electric pump, and also the means with which for me to check the fluid level via a standpipe and fill the transmission. And we'll look detailed closely at that in just a moment. Now, the first thing we need to do is remove the aluminum shield from the electrical connector. Of course, we noted that there is no mechanical linkage on the 9 G-tronic. All control is through CAN bus. Now, all fasteners in the magnesium aluminum case are aluminum. And here we start out with this fastener, which is no exception. And sure enough, this is an aluminum fastener. However, this fastener is threaded into a brass insert in the oil pan, and this fastener is definitely a steel fastener. Now we'll go ahead and start removing the pan bolts. Whoops. Here we have a aluminum fastener going into the magnesium aluminum case. All of the pan bolts are aluminum. Now, obviously, when working with aluminum fasteners, you're supposed to replace them anytime you have removed them from the transmission. Now, oftentimes when you buy a replacement filter oil pan assembly, it will come with new aluminum fasteners. However, as we go through the transmission, there'll be a large variety of aluminum bolts that are holding the bell housing to the case and the front pump to the case. It would be nice to replace these aluminum bolts, but they may not be readily available. Also, when torquing aluminum bolts, keep in mind that they are aluminum and the torque specs are going to be much lower than a corresponding steel bolt. Now, what's the big deal about aluminum? Corrosive tendencies between steel bolts and magnesium aluminum are considerable. And also expansion contraction properties of steel compared to aluminum magnesium are very different. So going to aluminum bolts has become very popular in the automotive industry, not only for transmission assemblies, like with the ZF, 8HP, and 9HP, but also with the Mercedes and BMW engines that are going to the magnesium aluminum alloy engine blocks. Okay, now after taking the fasteners off of the pan, I'm just carefully lifting it up. The resistance is, of course, the result of the pickup tubes for the two filters. This is the engine-driven filter. This is the electric pump filter. All right, now as we look over here, here is the method whereby I fill the transmission. And what's interesting is I have a plug that's very easily removed, and then I actually have a position that I will move the standpipe back and forth to either drain the fluid or fill and then measure the height. Okay, let's take a look at the drain plug and the fill port here for the 9G-tronic. Here I'm actually going to remove the plug. Remember, this is plastic. And as you can see, as I take it loose, there in the closed position, I'm going to line the arrows up with closed and simply about a half a turn, and she comes up on the ramps and comes right off. And there's the seal, is the O-ring. Now, what happens is that I actually can change the position of this tube right here to correspond to whether I want to drain the fluid or fill and check the level. And what's happening? What am I doing? Well, let's take a look. What I'm doing, if I want to drain, obviously what's happening is that I'm opening the passages here at the bottom, which will allow me to drain the level of the fluid down to this point. Here I can go ahead and fill and then check the level. And there's a maximum level and then a minimum level. And of course, I would want to go ahead and make sure that the fluid is at least at the minimum, but it would be nice to make sure that I had the maximum. And of course, obviously, there's a detailed procedure that Mercedes is specifying, actually, with a piece of equipment to actually fill the transmission, drain the transmission, and check the fluid level. Now, what fluid am I using? This is a later style fluid for the 9G-tronic, which is an amber in color. Okay, now we're ready to go ahead and remove the valve body from the case. And here we see the electric pump, the motor for the electric pump. There's the two pump pickups, and here we see the associated solenoids. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One nice trick here when working on the 9G-tronic, you know that any bolt that's going to go into the aluminum magnesium case is going to be aluminum. So obviously, when I get ready to remove the valve body, any bolt that is a steel bolt is definitely not going into the case. And here I can clearly identify the aluminum bolts that are holding the valve body to the magnesium aluminum case. Now this bolt is aluminum, it's just obviously this bracket is steel. But that bolt is definitely aluminum. There's another one right there. So here we go. Remember, aluminum. Be careful using air tools. And also remember, the torque is going to correspond to an aluminum bolt. And again, aluminum bolts are supposedly one-time use. But here, this transmission is being used for training and research, so obviously these are going to be taken in and out many, many times. And there, even on the first disassembly, the torque on an aluminum bolt is going to be much less than a corresponding steel bolt of equal size. Also, when working with the Torx driver, be careful choosing a size that's a little too small, can easily strip out an aluminum bolt. And what I mean by strip out, I mean strip the head. This transmission has been apart several times, and the oil has been carefully drained from it. This transmission only had 1,300 miles on it before the vehicle was involved in a major accident and went to the automotive recycling facility. Now, obviously, the aluminum bolt that's holding the electric pump bracket to the case is going to be much shorter than the aluminum bolts retaining the valve body to the case. The aluminum bolts retaining the valve body to the case are all the same size. You'll notice that I don't have any manual linkage to deal with, and as we'll see in a moment, the input speed sensor, intermediate speed sensor, and output speed sensor are all part of the integrated hydraulic electronic unit. Okay, now that we have removed all the aluminum fasteners retaining the valve body to the case, we want to go ahead and remove it. Now, one thing that you want to do is there's an O-ring right here on the case connector, and let's just take a quick look at this case connector. These five terminals are the only control connection between the vehicle and the transmission, and we see power and ground, and CAN high and low and diagnostic. Now we're ready to go ahead and carefully lift the valve body up. As we do so, a good safe place to simply place this. One easy place to store the valve body while we're disassembling the rest of the transmission is just simply set it back in the pan. And here I'm just setting it right on the filter pickups. Here we see the standpipe for filling the transmission and measuring the fluid level. Now here we have the electronic hydraulic unit that includes the transmission control module. And here we see the turbine speed sensor and the intermediate speed and output speed sensor. I believe actually this is the turbine speed, strangely enough. What's happening is that the turbine is actually driving one of the rear planetary members, so it's a good place to pick it up. Intermediate speed and output speed sensor.